Assembly elections in the electoral history of Punjab have been always fought between Congress and Shiromani Akali Dal. However, with Aam Aadmi Party in fray this time, the political equation stand changed. We would try to understand more on this. We are joined by the Finance Minister of Punjab, Parminder Singh Dhindsa. It's a pleasure to have you here, sir.
Thank you, Vinay.
With Aap in fray, how do you look at the political changing political equations? Because the contest is going to be tri-corner this time.
I think, as if you go by the past history, the Akali BJP alliance has always benefited from a triangular contest.
Right.
So if the votes are evenly split up, or maybe with some difference within the Congress and Aam Aadmi Party, it will benefit the ruling alliance. And I am pretty sure that we'll be coming back to power.
Perfect. Whenever we speak to Congress and Shiromani Akali Dal leaders, they always try to downplay the Aam Aadmi Party factor. But the rural ground reports, they always suggest that they will be a force, they are a force in the reckoning. Okay, and many draw parallels to the rise of the rise and fall of People's Party of Punjab. Whereas, I mean, that was just a very small state party, I mean, largely limited to two or three constituencies. And this time, I mean, they are already ruling Delhi. They have already formed a government in Delhi. So what do you say on that?
You know, firstly, initially, there was a deep impact of AAP in Punjab, if you look back 1 year or so. But subsequently, you know, as AAP's policies have come out in the open, their performance in Delhi and their stand on various issues in Punjab.
Right.
Since then, their graph has gone down, and I personally feel that now their impact is much less than what we were anticipating. So I believe anyway, they're going to be a third force. They're not going to be one of the two, main parties.
Perfect. And Shiromani Akali Dal, it ruled in succession for the second time in the electoral history of Punjab, right? And anti-incumbency does seem to be a factor at the moment. And how do you look at it? I mean, you being the finance minister of state, would like to have answer.
You know, see,
on that
first. That similarly, in as far as ruling a state for a long period concerns. No, there are two ways you look at it. One is the anti-incumbency factor is there, no doubt, we can't deny it.
Right.
But secondly, there is also a factor where over the past 10 years, our policies have benefited a lot of people. So a lot of people who were not sympathetic towards Akali Dal in the past, maybe the poor Dalits, are now tilting towards Akali Dal just because of the pro-poor policies, pro-farmer policies of the Akali Dal, or of the transparent way in which the employment has taken place. So all these factors have also helped in tilting some vote towards the Akali Dal. If there is anti-incumbency, there is also a factor where our performance, our development and other performances of the government has benefited us.
Right. And so one very positive development which we witness at the sea at the moment is that the agenda has been shifting. I mean, it used to be a religious agenda earlier, and now the agenda seems to be primarily focused on development-based ideas. Right. Like the number of highways you got from the national, from center, I mean, from your ally BJP at center. And another infrastructure development on even the power surplus and all that. Okay. So do you think the agenda till elections would remain only development oriented only?
See, agendas are usually reliant on the psyche of the people. With changing times, people, you know, have, adopted a pro-development or a positive kind of agenda. They want people to talk positive. They want the politicians to deliver. So it is but natural that, core agendas have changed. Yes, Akali Dal is predominantly a Sikh party, and it represents the Sikhs all over the country, or I would say all over the world. So that is going to stay. But as far as Punjab politics is concerned, we have consciously decided that the major agenda should be communal harmony and development.
Right. And Mr. Dhindsa, you have been largely known as a very prudent finance minister for Punjab. And at the same time, when we see that the debt of rupees 1,30,000 crore I mean, that's actually seen as a very huge debt. Okay, how do you justify that? I mean, even at times when government is in on a laggies mode and throwing subsidies to the farmers in the to empower these farmers in the agrarian state.
The debt, if you look at debt, you can't look at it in an isolated manner.
Yes.
You have to have a complete view. Firstly, our debt has grown, but our debt has not grown at the pace it was growing earlier. You know, when we took over power, our debt was around 55,000 crores. In 10 years, it has reached 1,30,000 crores. And there are other factors, as you know, inflation and other factors have also contributed to it. And thirdly, our GDP has grown tremendously. It has grown from 1,40,000 crores to more than 15,000 crores. 4,15,000 crores.
Right.
So it's a threefold increase. So in real terms, our debt to GSDP has fallen down. It has fallen down from 42, but it was between 42 and 43%.
Right.
And now it is somewhere around 32%.
Right.
So our fiscal position has improved. There's no doubt about it. So the people who have always, you know, tried to project Punjab's finances in a very bad light, they also know heart of heart that the situation is not as bad as that they have been predicting or that they have been projecting in the media or whatever.
Perfect. And Punjab hosted progressive summits at Indian School of Business, and it did see conglomerates from national conglomerates and international conglomerates like Alan Mittal, Mr. Ambani here. Okay, so what has been the impact on the ground of these progressive summits we did here?
So we have had investments, and probably Punjab has the investor summits have been one of the most successful on the basis that more than 60% of our committed investments have been fruitful. You know, they have been government has entered into a agreement with them, and groundwork has started, and those projects have been implemented. So that's a big achievement. Going by, you know, what other investment summits of other states have yielded, our performance is much better. And a few months back, I had a talk with the HEMAL, which is a joint venture between the Hindustan Petroleum and Mittal Group.
Yes.
They are keen to double their investment and expand their production, or probably they want to add new products into their refining business. So apart from that, ITC had set up one of their very big ticket projects. Other business houses have also committed investments, and they have implemented that. So all in all, I think we're quite satisfied with the way the investors had promised us and how they've delivered.
Perfect. And so how do you look at the demonetization move? Because Election Commission has shown concerns that money can be replaced with liquor and gold and another things. How do you look at that?
Oh, it is a very positive step. It's a step in the right direction. And I think the government will follow up with more steps. It is one step which has, shown the commitment of the government, which has shown that the government really wants to, you know, do something about corruption. They want to deliver on black money, tax evasion. So all this can be linked to that. And, initially, you will have problems. People will face problems. I think people realize that as well, and they've accepted that. And in the coming month or so, things will ease out, and overall, this country will benefit from this demonetization move.
And so, do you think that it will cut down on the election expenditure as well?
Yes, I hope so. It will. You know, it will. Reduce the expenditure, and it will give birth to a more even democratic process.
Perfect. So coming to your constituency, you will be contesting from Lehra Ghagha. You are pissed against senior Congress leader Rajendra Kaur Bhattal, and she is contesting from the same constituency for the sixth time. So what is it? What are the core issues in hand you are likely to take on?
You know, there are always, you can't rely on one issue. There are a lot of issues concern about that area. There are micro level issues, there are macro level issues.